Where are we going?
Minnie Mouse.
We're gonna go see Minnie Mouse?
Yeah. I just see the Minnie Mouse.
Where the baby on the bus goes where all through the town.
Mommy on the bus goes shh, shh, shh.
The bus goes shh, all through the town.
Are they going tall and getting little? What happened? It went up? It's too tall now? Okay, go touch it. Go touch it. Oh no.
Glasses. I can see so clearly with them.
Good. Get the tree.
Yeah. Candy. Oh, ears. Turn around, Dad.
Look at me.
I heard you.
Nope. I'm recording too. I'm recording you recording. Keep it on, okay? Ben, Penelope.
Ben.
You're gonna keep it on, okay?
Colonial birds, and they'll often live in nests of up to 500 birds in one nest. Now, even though hippos have so much time underwater, they don't really swim. They just run or walk along the bottom. You might see a few walking along the bottom here in the river. Hippos will even sleep underwater. When they need to take a breath, they'll come up, take that breath, and go right back down, all while still staying asleep. The dogs are African wild dogs. And the painted dogs are actually the most successful predators out in the wild. They have about a 90% success rate. This is because they will chase their prey down to the point of exhaustion, and that's what makes them so very successful. They usually live in packs of about 5 to 15 in each pack, and they have an alpha male as the leader of their group. Wherever he goes, the others will pretty much follow. The springbok can jump up to 8 feet in the air when standing still. And when running, they can leap up to 15 feet forward. They can reach speeds up to 55 miles an hour. And they're the national symbol for South Africa. And what's in there? There's a few more springbok there as well. Over on the left-hand side here, do you see a few of the Maasai giraffe? And the Maasai giraffe is the tallest animals in the world. They can grow to be up to 20 feet tall.
See the giraffe?
They get their name from the irregular spot pattern that they have on their skin.
Yeah. Look. It's right there.
Just make sure we stay seated, please. Now, they spend most of their day eating, so their tongue is actually a purplish color. This allows their tongue to not get sunburned.
It's eating.
So much time at the body. Group of two or more giraffes is called a tower, so we definitely have a tower there on the left.
And the giraffes
only sleep for around 30 minutes a day, and they normally do it standing up. Yes, a little bit more previous. Now, this elephant doesn't seem to be alone, so we can assume that he is male. Males are often more solitary, while females and babies all live together. So one thing you can really do to help elephants out in the wild is to recycle any old cell phone
batteries. It went away.
Because the mining industry was a main battery.
Penny, where'd the elephant go? It went away.
The blood vessel tucked the giraffes behind their ears that allow them to release heat.
The elephant's eating, baby.
They can actually decrease their body temperature by up to 15 degrees Fahrenheit. Yeah, you also may notice some sand, dirt, or hay sprayed onto the elephant's back.
I know.
They do this to use it kind of like a natural sunblock and help protect their very sensitive skin. Coming up here on the left-hand side, you'll notice a couple of the greater flamingo. Now, the greater flamingo is the lightest shade of pink flamingo in the species. They get their coloring from their diet of brine shrimp. Now, they don't actually form that color until about 2 or 3 years of life. So you'll notice in your mixer, there's some smaller gray ones. They're newly hatched, and they'll start to form their color over time.
Wow.
And a group of flamingos is called a flamboyant. On the left-hand side, a pretty good view of the white rhinos. And the white rhinos are substantially larger than the black rhinos we might have saw over in the interior forest. The white rhino weighs about 5,000 pounds. Now, even though they weigh up to 5,000 pounds, they can still reach speeds up to 35 miles an hour.
Rhinos.
They run the gallop, which means at one point all 4 feet are off of the ground.
Right there.
And a group of two or more white rhinos called a crash. This is because they can really only see about 10 feet in front of them, so they'll really rely on other senses in order to make their way around.
See the rhinos?
Now, just past the mud pits there, you'll notice a couple of these scimitar horned oryx. Now, they're one of my favorite animals here on the reserve. The scimitar horned oryx is mostly found in desert areas. They have that white reflective coat to help them reflect the sunlight. They actually don't start to sweat until their inner body temperature reaches 150 degrees Fahrenheit. They go about 9 months without drinking water.
Jeez.
Now, to the left-hand side here, do you see a cheetah? Back down. Keep your eye out for cheetahs on the left-hand side. Cheetahs are the fastest land mammals in the world. They can reach speeds up to 70 miles an hour. They can only maintain that high rate of speed for a few hundred yards. when cheetahs run, they use their tail kind of like a runner. It helps them change directions quickly since they're moving at such top speeds.
Oh.
And when cheetahs hunt, they hunt during the day. This gives them less competition between them and other
you
big
see the
cats.
Cheetah?
Yeah, I see it.
Oh,
lion.
See the lion? I think so. You see him?
See the lion?
See the lion?
I'm up to get a picture.
Alright, never mind. Oh, see, ostrich. Look at these.
Oh, wow. Now,
you see the ostrich?
If they find a burrow, then don't ask
ostrich.
Alright, there you go.
Mommy? Look at the ostrich.
He's
looking at us.
Just something about there is the ward does have a couple of the domesticated Nigerian dwarf goats.
Oh.
These goats are pretty popular here in Africa. They basically eat anything. So farmers will domesticate them, have them around in order to clear out certain parts of their pasture. As well as the goats provide milk, as well as goat cheese, to be able to sell them.
You see the goats?
The goats and the farmers all work together.
The other one helped it into the hole. Tap the monkey.
Penny, what is it? A turtle? Let's see. A Galapagos. Baby, what is it? Turtle. Is it a big turtle?
I can see it, Mommy.
How many are there?
Two.
Very good. Huh? Oh. What is it?
It's a hippo. There's one more hippo? I don't know.
Oh, the bird.
Oh, it's getting warmer.
Going swimming.
They don't swim, they walk or run.
That's right.
There it goes. Let's see if we can see it underwater.
He's huge. Look at that mouth.
Mouth.
That is. That's pretty cool. Look.
Oh, you're so cute.
Oh my goodness.
He's like, take my picture, everybody. He's teasing so very hard.
Such a hard day.
I want your life, dude.
Wow.
Can I hold this breath for 8 minutes?
Did it say 8 minutes?
Yeah.
And they like still like breathe while sleeping, like you go, yeah. They go up and.
Oh. It's sleeping, I know.
Dad!
It's a meerkat.
Meerkat.
Sounds good in the nest. It's so cute.
Wow. And that's the son. He's 6 years old.
He just has his legs crossed. He's sitting on one of those black poles. If you look to your right, you're going to see. Oh, he flipped it over. And they don't really eat out of those bowls. It's called enrichment. So they have different enrichment pools every day. So tomorrow they
won't
have these black poles. It's important that they're using their enrichment. It's a good sign that they're well adjusted.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Wow.
Oh. Hello, everyone. Good morning. We are the Discovery Island Drummers. And we wish you all a very Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays.
Three things more.
Nimun.
I'll sing your name.
Now we got it. I know.
Nothing is going to beat this Christmas lights.
Right? How are you looking at them? Oh. It's a show. Look at them windows. See Minnie.
There's food and beverage in there.
I know. We're gonna get hot chocolate and ice cream.
There's whack-a-mole.
Can you see Penny? Can you see baby? What's happening?
Santa.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's cool. Oh, 228. See it on the map?
Hi, Ben.
What do you think of all the Christmas lights?
Something amazing.
They do it.
Yeah. You like it?
Yeah. Mommy. Oh, mommy.
What?
Tell.
Oh, careful. See the car?
Oh, mom.
What is it?
Gingerbread.
Wait. Come over here.
That way right
there.
Let's take a look at
that.
Thank you.
There's the hot cocoa there. Oh, is that a Mario mushroom? Here, let's go this way.
Okay.
The tree is snoring.
I have that.
You hear the tree?
Yeah.
It's snoring. It's sleeping.
I guess it does look like it's sleeping.
Oh, look at the floor. Babe, the mushroom is a carousel.
It's a what?
It's a carousel.
Oh, it's a
carousel.
Oh, there is a Minnie Mouse over there. Penny, get over here, baby.
You see the giraffes?
Yeah, the giraffe is eating.
The giraffe is eating?
Yeah.
What's the giraffe eating?
No one.
You don't know? Dinosaur! Right in front of you. Right there.
That's a dinosaur.
Molly, look up there. What's it? What is it, baby?
Oh!
It's a train!
Is it away?
It's going away! What do you think, Pen? Penny, look, a bunny.
A bunny?
No, no, over here.
Look, a bunny. Look, come here.
Come here. Go wave. Go say hi.
Go say hi.
You can go say hi. Go with their mama.
Go with mama.
Say hi, Pen. All right, say bye-bye. Okay, Ripley's Believe It or Not, the tallest man.
Oh, that's cool. That's the owl. No, not the owl. I can't
imagine being that tall.
Dino holiday.
Okay.
We just kind of passed. So we're like right here.
Fancy shoes. I can't see.
and a sparkle.
You say thank you.
Penny, you on a train?
It's amazing. That is too.
Smoke coming up?
Yeah.
You on a train?
Yeah.
What do you think, Mom?
It's amazing. That is too.
Smoke coming up?
Yeah. Actually pull that down.
Welcome aboard everybody in case of emergency.
Hey TJ, I'm me. Love you, Picasso.
London.
Death Eaters.
It's getting dark, Amber.
Let's find a compartment.
Could you use a snack? Where's the food trolley? Come on, can't you conjure up some pumpkin pasties?
Wrong. Food is the first of the five principal exceptions to Gamp's law of elemental transfiguration.
Do you know what she's talking about?
It's hard because there's stuff going on both sides.
Say you'd earned it.
And
it's your
frog.
Oh dear. Best get back to your seats now. I'll try and round up these little runaways.
Hey, don't.
Welcome, everyone.
magical holiday season. This Christmas at Hogwarts is an extra special one, as this year we are host to the Triwizard Tournament, and with it comes the Yule Ball. The walls of the Great Hall will be covered in sparkling silver frost as the students dance the night away under the enchanted starry night sky. Incantation.
I cast a spell on Father Christmas, hope to make him see that the nice and not the naughty list is where I ought to be. I cast a spell on Father Christmas, but it made him disappear. Now I'm in trouble, no witch or muggle will have Christmas this year. Ho, 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 I cast a spell on Father Christmas, sent him to the great beyond. I'll get laughed out of glass unless I learn to use my wand. I cast a spell on Father Christmas, but I had the wrong spell book. So he disappeared from boots to gear. Now my Christmas goose is cooked.
This year with such festive decor, Christmas at Hogwarts is truly a sight to behold.
Our final song is one I'm sure many of you will recognize.
We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. Good tidings for Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas.
Some figgy pudding, now bring us some figgy pudding, now bring us some figgy pudding and drink some right here.
And we won't come till we get some, we won't come till we get some, we won't come until we get some, so bring some right here.
They will be administering hand sanitizer for each guest prior to boarding, as well as providing specific seating assignments for each travel party. Hand sanitizer will also be available at the exit of this attraction. As a reminder, all guests are required to wear face covering during their visit, which includes while experiencing this attraction. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask one of our Universal team members. Thank you again for your attention, and enjoy the rest of your day here at Universal Orlando Resort.
Yes, just think, the next great witch or wizard could be walking through this room right now, unaware of their hidden talents, just like Harry Potter.
Potter! The boy who lived, the boy who survived by the seat of his pants is more like it.
Ah, but you're wrong, Salazar. It was love that saved young Harry, not luck.
Witchcraft and wizardry. And as you look around, this is one of the things where young people are inspired magically.
Not bad to be in this club with you. Keep your voices down, don't you hear us? Just a little noise.
now.
Splices. No, look, British, actually.
Did you really have to do that?
Honestly, Ron, they're just sweet. Describe him? That's hard. I don't know if I can.
Who
he said with a sawdusty sneeze. Who am I? I'm the Lorax, guardian of the forest. I speak for the trees. And then he became quite loud as he huffed. He was very upset as he shouted and puffed. Look, Lorax, I said, there's no cause for alarm. I chopped just one tree. I'm doing no harm. You have been warned, he cried. I speak for the trees. Well, I'm busy, I told him. Shut up, please. Oh, I meant no harm. I most truly did not. But I had to grow bigger, so bigger I got. I figured my factories, I figured the roads, I figured the wagons, I figured the loads of the needs I shipped out. I was shipping them forth, to the south, to the east, to the west, to the north. And for your information, you Lorax, I'm figuring, I'm figuring, and figuring, and figuring, and figuring, turning more truculent trees into feeds which everyone needs. Which way does a tree fall? He then asked solemnly. A tree falls the way it leans. Be careful which way you lean. And at that very moment, we heard a loud whack. From outside in the fields came a sickening smack of an axe on a tree. Then we heard that tree fall. The very last truculent tree of them all. But there's good news, my friends. A message to share. The Lorax knows change starts with you, if you dare. It's just one tiny seed, but that's all we really need. Imagine Needville flower tree. Unless someone like you cares a whole awful lot, nothing's going to get better. It simply will not. So be kind to the trees and be kind to our earth. Yes, you make the difference. Show our world what it's worth. Look what you thought, what you have done. My friends want to stay for lots more fun. They want to see and take pictures with you. So welcome Sam I Am and the Lorax Tunes.
Moo like a cow. It can go moo, moobity moo. The trolley train can do it. Hey, how about you?
Moo, moobity moo.
Can you sound like a circus organ? The trolley train can boop. How about you? Can you go boop-boop-boop-boop? Say, how about a walrus? Or the whistling breeze of a flying trapeze? Swoop, zoom, zoop. Is there such a thing as an upside-down sound? Listen to this. It goes swim, swim, swim. Are you feeling keen to hear the star on the scene? The trolley train goes back, sounding all trafficy. How about you? Can you go beep?
Honkity honk, beep beep beep.
When the trolley train goes rolling past, we know how it sounds to go really fast. With a swish, swoosh, kablast. Now don't you be last. Make the sound of fast.
Swish, swoosh, kablast.
Oh, the mighty trolley train makes a round hullabaloo. It's the sound of fun. Can you make it too?
Wee, wee, woohoo!
Like a beach ball, the trolley train is going boing, 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 boing. Boom, boom, the trolley train is a wonder. Boom, boom, hear the waves thunder. Oh, listen to this. What an ear full of luck. We can hear the sound of old McBean's truck. Bang, bonk, chug. Can you make that sound too?
Bang, bonk, chug, bang, bonk, chug.
And a sneech farewell to toodaloo, toodaloo. Time for the trolley train to say toodaloo now. How about you?
Toodaloo, toodaloo.
So goodbye, sneeches. Goodbye all around. We won't forget all the wonderful sounds.
Here. Come here.
Wow, thanks for having me.
for sitting there proving that there is such thing as stupid questions. I had to bang my head against the wall to give me the courage to stay out here.
Hi, who's this? Penny?
Yeah.
Oh. Was she good this year?
Yeah, you hesitated there for a second. Is she your little sister?
Yeah. How was she this year, bud?
Yeah, she doesn't want to answer that question.
Did you get all sorts of wonderful gifts for Christmas? Did you?
You did.
You got a dinosaur? So will you. I like those things. They look almost as vicious as me.
Oh, I was hoping for something a little more destructive. Maybe a blowtorch.
Right.
That'd be pretty sweet.
Yeah.
What kid doesn't need one of those?
What'd you say?
I couldn't hear you. Was it something stupid?
Yes.
Yeah, probably. That's a dinosaur. That thing is huge. It's probably bigger than you. Are you going to be able to manage that thing? No. Yeah, that's how I feel about myself constantly.
Me too.
Every problem to me is just one big giant, what is that thing called? Can you spell it out for me? We'll just stick to dinosaur. Keeps it nice and simple. We don't need the Latin name anyhow.
Don't ring the Christmas morning bell.